In this tutorial, I'm going to identify five key parts of light across an object and how to light a still life for value drawings in my class. Let's start by identifying the parts of light. Here is an example of direct light across an object. The light source is located here and is directly pointed towards the object. Here we have the highlight. It is the lightest in value. It is in high key. It is the brightest area of illumination. Then we have low light areas. While these areas are not as light as the highlight, they're still well lit because these areas are still making contact with the light rays. Then we have core shadows. These areas are turned away from the light rays. They are darkest in tone. They are in low key. Details are difficult to see in core shadows because they lack illumination. Then we have cast shadow, which is created by the object and extends in the direction away from the light source. A successfully drawn cast shadow is governed by the linear rules of perspective while maintaining its unique shape. Lastly, we have reflective light. Light waves are bouncy. Reflective light is light that is being bounced back onto an object from some other object. It is a weak light source and is present in the shadows, typically along the contours. Being able to identify these five parts of light can help you navigate complex lighting situations. Now, I should clarify that this example is a very simplified lighting scenario. Most situations you'll encounter will have multiple lighting sources present at the same time. So think of these five parts as a key to a map or as a compass to help you find your way when you're lost. Now, there are two types of light that I want you to be conscious of: direct light or hard light, and indirect light or soft light. The example I have presented here is with direct light or hard light. This is because the clamp light is pointed directly at the object. The result is shadows with hard edges. We can basically see the shadow line or contour. Here's another example of hard light. Now check this out. This is indirect light or soft light. Notice that the edges of the shadows have softened. Instead of seeing a shadow line, we see a field of mid-tone. This lighting scenario is created by diffusing the light. Diffused light is light rays that have been broken up so they indirectly illuminate. This can be achieved by bouncing light off of another surface or by shining a light through a translucent material. Basically, think of it this way. A clear sunny day is an example of direct light. A cloudy overcast day is an example of indirect light because the light rays are being diffused and broken up by the clouds. For my class, I want you to use direct light for your still lives when creating a value drawing at home. In this photo, I'm using a $10 clamp light I bought from a hardware store. If you don't have a lamp of some kind, you can use the flashlight feature from your cell phone. Or you can upload a photo of an all-white image to your computer, up the brightness of the screen, and use it as a makeshift lamp. Whatever you do, don't use the sunlight from a window. Sunlight from the window is not a reliable light source to learn value drawing. Once you've decided on your light source, adjust the light so that the objects are half to three quarters lit. In other words, light the objects so that half to a quarter of the object's surface is with a core shadow. Because this means that half to 3/4 of the object will be lit. This is known as half to 3/4 lighting. Lastly, while you want to do your best to only have one light source illuminating your still life, you still have to be able to see what you're drawing. So make sure that your still lifes are lit bright enough to achieve half to 3/4 lighting without the need to overly dim your room to the point that your eyes are strained while drawing.